So what was Beatlemania to you at that, at the height of it, when it was its busiest, what, 1964, 65?
No sleep with all the mail.
How many letters a week were you getting, roughly?
Oh, God. Thousands. 2,000 to 3,000 a day. Must have sat up till 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. Just answering, I used to do all what we call detail letters. I used to just bring all them home and then go back to work with my little parcel the next day. I don't know how I lived.
Baby's good to me, you know she's happy as can be, you know she said so. I'm in love with her and I feel fine.
The type of questions kids would ask in the fan club letters was, you know, can I have a piece of Paul's shirt? Or if I send you a map, can you ask Paul to come round at 6 o'clock? Because I'm having a party and I'd like him to come.
I'm so glad that she's my little girl.
But then it got a bit out of hand because then people wanted hair and it was the same barber that cut their hair. It was always this one guy. I mean, it was there, they'd probably do DNA on it now. He would have like a mat down on the floor or something and cut the hair, and then it's, because he thought I was mental. And he'd just say, there you go, do you want that bit? I go, yeah, thanks. Somebody sent a pillowcase in and said, can you get Richie to sleep on this pillowcase and then send it back to me and get him to sign it. I must have known that he was going to be home for 3 days. So I just threw that in my bag and took it to his house and said, can you sleep on that tonight? And sign it then. And I remember saying to Elsie, that was his mum, can you make sure he sleeps on it? You know? Anyway, he brought it in, you know, just said, yeah. And then I just sent it out to the girl. Whether she believed me or not that he'd slept on it, but he did. He put his head on that pillow.
She's in love with me and I feel fine.
Honestly, if I could do it, I would do it. Because, you know, I was one of them. I was a fan myself. So I knew where they were coming from.